as you can see into this slide, there are three parameters or characteristics which combined together makes an entrepreneur a complete entrepreneur. These are gifts. Gifts are something which is you have by birth or which is there into your family DNA. To take an example, I belong to a family from in which everybody is from either from maths background or from engineering background. So I automatically that the analytical gift is into my DNA. The next is hurt. Hurt, what we generally call, I am passionate about something. I am really wanted to do this. And the hurt is that what you are passionate about. And the third is skills. So what is exactly skill? Skill is something which you learn or developed over a period of time. It can be anything. It can be your education. It can be something which you are doing as a hobby, but over a period of time, you become an expert into it. So when we talk about skills, suppose that somebody want to be an entrepreneur into artificial intelligence, but he has nothing to do with coding. He is a commerce graduate or a, you can say, bio graduate. So the skill set is not there. So he won't be able to justify his entrepreneurial dreams into the domain of artificial intelligence. So these are three factors which are combined together makes you a talented person, which you see the person with the stars above his head, makes you a talented person for being an entrepreneur. To take it further and take it to the next step of understanding yourself as an entrepreneur, we have created an exercise. The complete exercise is divided into four parts. In these four parts, first is where we will try to identify the gifts that we are having. Then we are trying to identify the hurt, that is the passion that we have to do anything. Then we are trying to identify the skill sets at which we are good. There are separate seats for everything. You just need to put the answers of the questions along with the seat, and automatically at the end of the exercise, you will able to identify whether you can be an entrepreneur in certain domain or sector or not. The last seat is for the brainstorming seat, which is one way of identifying an idea which is around you, what you see and what you not. So the first seat which you are seeing onto the screen, it is the gift discovery seat. As we already discussed that there are three factors which three characteristics which when combined together decides whether you are an entrepreneur or not. The first is the gift discovery seat. So if you can scroll down through the seat, you can see the directions out there, how this seat need to be filled. There will be answer from your side as well as you need to also talk to other people and ask these questions about you. Just fill it just fill this exercise seat. Apart from that, there are other discovery seats also. That is the love discovery seat, which is like how passionate you are about something. There are it is similar to the gift discovery seat. There will be question, you just need to answer them. You can go through it and just answer them. And similarly, there is skill discovery seat, which is also similar to the gift discovery seat. All combined, you will come to the seat which will be the talent work seat. Just go through the direction of the talent seat, but to briefly explain it, you are going to put the number one gift out there, you are going to put the number one passionate thing about what you want to do there, and then you are going to put the number one skill set. Now try to identify what you can do combining all these three. So if you can combine all these three and work on anything, that is sure sort going to be success, because you are gifted for it. You are passionate about it and you also have the skill set to raise that startup or to run that business. So just try to find out these. At the bottom of the seat, you can see that you can put three talents out there. Suppose, let's go back to the top. So let's see how we are going to identify the talent. As I already mentioned that I have a gift of analysis. Analytics is into my DNA. Second, I am really passionate about the data sciences, how the data are analyzed and used to come up with indicators or come up with solution. Skills. I am a certified programmer. I started my career as a programmer, though after some time I left it. Apart from that, from time to time, I keep on learning new programming languages. Recently, I have completed my Python. When we combine these three all together, that will be gift, will be analytic. passion will be data sciences, and my skill set will be I am a programmer. So if you see the talent which I got, I can easily start a startup which is dealing into data sciences and artificial intelligence or machine learning, you can say, and I will do good at it because I know, because I am also gifted for it, I am passionate for it, and I also have the skill set for it. You will find all the exercise sheets as attachment. Just download them, fill it, ask your friend to fill it for you. Just try to identify your talent. Finding out the talent that you possess is the first step into startup ecosystem. It is you like being a toddler founder taking its first step for understanding his or her talent. Then further in other sessions, we are going to identify the idea. We will brainstorm. There are 2-3 methods of identifying the right idea. We will also see the exact definition of startups, and we will see what are the different type of organizations, entrepreneurial organization which can be raised. And just do the find out the talent, and in the coming sessions we'll be talk about identifying the ideas, then we'll be assessing the idea, we'll be market sizing it, then we'll be talking a lot about Porter's 5 O's model. There are a lot of things into idea validations, but this is the first step. As I say, this is founder toddler founder's first step toward raising a startup. Find out your talent. And in the next session, we are going to talk about identification of idea. There are 2 ways of identification of idea. One is the brainstorming, and the second is the A/B testing. So we will be going to discuss about the first style of idea identification first, and then the A/B testing. And before that, we will talk a bit about what exactly startups are, what is the definition, what is the right definition of startups. And we will also talk a bit about what are the different categories of businesses and how you can reach to an idea. Till then, bye. Hopefully, you will take up the exercise and you will try to identify the talents that you have into you. And hopefully, by the end of this program, we will be able to validate one of the ideas which will be complementing your talent so that you can further raise a successful startup. Till then, bye. See you soon, guys.